A photocell is a device which converts radiant energy into electrical energy. This figure is a simple diagram of the circuit of a photocell, which includes a dry cell, an ammeter A, a cathode, which is a pure metal, and an anode. We consider two photocells of cesium and zinc cathodes, whose work functions are 1.89 electron volts and 4.31 electron volts, respectively. We illuminate each of the above cells by a light of wavelength 0.5 micrometers in vacuum. Number one, calculate the energy of an incident photon in electron volt. The energy of the photon is given by this expression, hc over lambda. H is Planck's constant, c is the speed of light in vacuum, and lambda is the wavelength of the incident light. Replace each physical quantity by its value. We get the energy of the photon in joules. It is 39.72 times 10 to the power minus 20 joules, but we want the energy of the photon in electron volts. 1 electron volt equal 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Then, divide the energy of the photon in joules by 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19. Then, the energy of the photon is 2.48 electron volts.
2.1. Electrons are not liberated from the surface of zinc. Why? Since 2.49 electron volts, which is the energy of an incident photon, is less than 4.31 electron volts, which is the work function of zinc, therefore no electrons are liberated from the surface of zinc. 2.2. Determine the maximum wavelength lambda zero of a radiation capable of liberating electrons from the surface of zinc. The maximum wavelength can be determined using this relation. Rearrange lambda 0 equals hc over w0. Hc and lambda 0 are expressed in SI units, so w0 should be also expressed in SI units. Now replace each physical quantity by its value. W0 equals 4.31 electron volts, which is equivalent into 4.31 times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Therefore, lambda 0 equals 288 times 10 to the power minus 9 meters.
Let's move to part 3.1. Calculate the maximum kinetic energy of an electron emitted from the surface of cesium in electron volts. Let's use Einstein's photoelectric equation. The energy of the photon equals the work function of the metal plus the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electron. Replace the energy of the photon by 2.49 electron volts, the work function by 1.89 electron volts. Then, the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electron must be expressed in electron volts. It is 0.600 electron volts. Let's move to part 3.2. Deduce the maximum speed of this electron. The kinetic energy of the electron is given by this expression, 1/2 mvm squared. Be careful with the units. The mass is expressed in kilograms, whereas the maximum kinetic energy is expressed in electron volts. So we need to convert the electron volt into joules. 1 electron volt equals 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Then replace the maximum kinetic energy of the electron by 0.600 times 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. The mass is expressed in kilograms. Then the maximum speed of the electron must be expressed in SI units, or in meters per second. It is equal to 4.59 times 10 to the power 5 meters per second.
Focus, please. This is important.
Given that the power of the incident radiation equals 0.398 watts, and the number of electrons emitted per second is 1 times 10 to the power 16 electrons. 4.1. Calculate the number n of photons received by the cesium cathode in 1 second. We use this equation. The power of the incident radiation equals the number of the photons received by the cesium cathode times the energy of each photon over the time. Rearrange, then N equals P times T over E photon. Now, replace each physical quantity by its value. Therefore, N equals 1 times 10 to the power 18 photons. 4.2. Calculate the quantum efficiency of this cesium cathode. The quantum efficiency is given by the number of the effective photons over the number of photons received by the cesium cathode during the same time. We know that N equals 1 times 10 to the power 18 photons per second, but the number of the effective photon during 1 second equals the number of the electrons emitted during 1 second, which is equal to 1 times 10 to the power 16. Now, replace N effective and N by their values. Therefore, the quantum efficiency equals 0.01, which is equal to 1%.
Let's move to part 4.3. Assume that all the ejected electrons are captured by the anode and the transfer in the wires. Calculate the current measured by the ammeter. The expression of a constant current is Q over T, where Q is the absolute value of electric charge which crosses a point in the conductor during a time T. But Q equals N times E, where E is the electron charge and N is the number of the electrons crossing the wire during a time T. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of this current, which is 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes. Let's move to part 5.1. For the cesium metal, write the expression of the maximum kinetic energy of an emitted electron as a function of the frequency nu of the incident light. Let's use Einstein's photoelectric equation. Replace the energy of the photon by h nu, where h is Planck's constant. Rearrange, you will get this equation. Now, in order to get the expression of the maximum kinetic energy as a function of the frequency nu, we need to replace h and w0 by their values. But be careful with the units. H is expressed in SI units, while w0 is expressed in electron volts. So we need to express w0 in joules. 1 electron volt equals 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Then, let's replace W0 by 1.89 times 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Now, W0 is expressed in SI units. H is expressed in SI units. Now, you will get the relation between the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electron and the frequency of the incident light. And this equation is expressed in SI units.
5.2. Draw the curve of Ke maximum versus nu. The expression of Ke maximum is proved in the previous slide. Ke maximum equals a constant multiplied by nu plus another constant. So Ke maximum versus nu has the form of a straight line. To draw a straight line, we need the coordinates of two points. Let's find the coordinates of the first point. For Ke maximum equals 0, nu equals 4.57 times 10 to the power 14 Hz. Now, let's find the coordinates of the second point. For nu equals 8 times 10 to the power 14 Hz, Ke maximum equals 2.27 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Now, we plot these two points and then we join these two points to get the straight line.